Hello everyone. In this video, I will explain the Dijkstra's shortest path algorithm. The Dijkstra's shortest path algorithm is one of the most popular and widely used algorithm for finding the shortest distance between two vertices in a graph. So the name Dijkstra is actually the name of the computer scientist who proposed this algorithm for the first time. So when you pronounce the name, you had to make J and K silent. Here I have given a graph, and over each edge I have written a number that is the cost associated to travel from V2 to V5. Our aim is to find the shortest distance from a given vertex to every other vertex in the graph. Okay, so at the end we will get some distances associated with each of these vertex. Those distances will be the shortest distance that you can reach at that particular vertex starting from the first vertex V1. Okay, so in this example, I'm treating V1 as the starting vertex. You can take any other vertex if the application demands so. Okay, so the algorithm is quite simple. So what we have to do is, for each vertex V in G, where G is my graph, this graph, for each vertex V in G, we have certain variables associated with each of the vertices. The first one is a known array, then the distance array, dist array, and path array. Okay, so we have to initialize these values to begin with. So we have to create a table to track the values of these variables during the execution of the algorithm. So I have given a table here, V, for listing the vertices, and we will be giving the corresponding values for these variables under the table. So first we have to initialize known of V equal to false for this particular algorithm. So I will be writing 0 instead of false in this table. First I have to list all the vertices in the graph. So I have V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6, and V7, and I had to make known of V equal to false. So I'm writing all those values equal to 0 that represent the value false. Okay, then distance should be equal to int max. That should be a maximum value in the beginning. So I'll be writing infinity for simplicity. So distance is infinity for all the vertices. Okay, now path of V equal to null. Instead of writing null, I will be writing again 0 in the table for simplicity. So 0, 0, 0. Okay, now to comment on these variables, the known variable represent whether we had found the shortest path to that particular vertex so far. If the value is 0, we haven't found any shortest path to that particular vertex. If it is 1 or true, then we have already considered that vertex. So then the distance of V or dist of V represent the shortest path to a vertex V, and path of V represent which should be the previous vertex that I need to consider in order to find the shortest path to the vertex V. You will see the significance of this variable soon. Now in the beginning, you have to consider a starting vertex, that is the start vertex. So in this question, I am taking the start vertex as V1. So we have to assign the distance of that vertex V1 to 0 to begin with. So instead of infinity, I will be writing 0 over here. Okay, so this will be 0, which means that the distance to reach the vertex V1 is 0 because we are starting from that point. So I'm writing the distances near to all the vertices. So first we have a 0 distance, then we have infinity for all other vertices. So this will be infinity, 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 and infinity. Okay. All right. Now we will be running an infinite while loop, and this while loop will break if this condition satisfies. So in the beginning, I have to take V equal to smallest unknown distance vertex. That means the vertex should be unknown, which means that known of V should be false. A known array, so all vertices are unknown. And this is a distance array, so the smallest distance will be for V1. So we are assigning V equal to the smallest unknown distance vertex, that is V1. Presently my V is V1. Now we are checking whether V is null. V is not null because V is V1, so it will not break the while loop. So we have to make the value of known of V1 equal to true. Okay, so I will do that. That is, I will change this value from 0 to 1 or from false to true. Okay, now we have to consider each of the adjacent vertices of V one by one and we will be calling those adjacent vertices as W. If you examine the adjacent vertices of V1, we have two vertices, they are V2 and V4. So I'll be writing those vertices here to make the discussion more clear. So the first one is V2, the second one is V4. First, we will check whether those vertices are known or not. So if it is not known, that is if it is unknown, which means known of W equal to false, then we will be stepping through these procedures. So we will consider the case of V2 first. The known status of V2 is false, which means that V2 is unknown. So it will be getting into this if condition. So first we will check whether dist of V2 is greater than dist of V1 plus the cos from V1 to V2. So the dist of V2 is presently infinity. The dist of V1 is 0. So the cos from V1 to V2 is 2. So without a doubt, the infinity is greater than 2. So it will enter into this if condition. So it will change the value of dist of V2 to this new value, that is 0 plus 2. So now the value of dist of V2 will become 0 plus 2 or 2. Okay. So I will make that change in my table as well as in the diagram. So the dist of V2 is now the value 2. Okay. So I will make that change here as well. Okay. So that is the distance from V1 to V2, that is 2, which is nothing but the cos of this edge. Now we have to do one more thing, that is we have to assign path of V2 equal to V1. Okay. So presently the path of V2 is nothing or null. So we will be writing V1 over there. So this will be V1. Okay. So we have done with the vertex V2. Now we will go for V4. So first we have to check whether V4 is unknown. So V4 is indeed unknown. Now we have to take the cos of V4. The cos of V4 is presently infinity. We'll check whether it is greater than the dist of V1. Dist of V1 is 0 plus the cost of traveling from V1 to V4. V1 to V4, the cost is 1. So obviously infinity is greater than 1. So we have to change the dist of V4 to 1. So I will do that changes. So the dist of V4 is 1. And I need to change this value as well as this value. Okay. So the dist of V4 is 1, the path of V4 is V1 because presently the value of V is V1, and similarly I will be changing the cost here as well. I will give the value 1. Okay. So we have done with V4 also. Okay. So we have done with this for statement. So I have done with these values. Now we have to go back to the while loop. So in the while loop, the condition is true. So we will be picking the smallest as well as the unknown distance vertex from the entire graph. Okay. So these are the unknown vertices and these are the distance of those vertices. So presently the smallest vertex which is unknown is V4. Okay. So that will be coming to the variable V. So V will be now V4. Now the value of V is not null. So this will not break. Now we have to assign known of V equal to true. So I will do that. That is known of V should be assigned with the value 1. Okay. Now we will be checking every adjacent vertices of V4. So we will run these conditions accordingly. Okay. If you look at the vertex V4, V4 has got 4 vertices, that is V3, V6, V7 and V5. Okay. So I will write those vertices over here. V3, V6, V7 and V5. Okay. Now we will check the known status of each vertices. First we will consider the case of V3. So the known of V3 is false. Essentially known of V3 is false. Now we have to check the distances. So the distance to V3 is presently infinity. Distance to V4 is presently 1. So this is the distance of V4 or this value. Okay. So it is 1 plus the cost of traveling from V4 to V3. So V4 to V3, the cost is 2. So obviously this condition is true. So we have to make the changes. So I will be assigning the distance of V3 to 1 plus 2, that is 3. Okay. So V3 has got a distance of 3. And I will be writing the path variable of V3 as V4. So this will be V4. Now I need to make changes here also. So I'll be writing 3 over here. So we have done with V3. Now we will consider V6, whether V6 is known or not. So V6 is unknown currently. So we will be checking for the next condition. The distance to V6 is currently infinity. Whether infinity is greater than distance to V4 is 1 plus the distance from V4 to V6. V4 to V6, the distance currently is 8. So this will be 9. So indeed infinity is greater than 9. So we had to make these changes. So I'll be changing the distance value of V6 to 9. Then I will assign path of V6 equal to V4. Okay. So I will be changing these two values. Similarly, this value. Okay. So the distance to V6 is 9 and path of V6 is V4. Okay. So we have done with V6. Now we will consider V7. So V7 is unknown, which means the value is 0. So we will check this condition. Distance of V7 currently is infinity. Whether infinity is greater than distance to V4 is 1. And distance from V4 to V7 is 4. So obviously infinity is greater than 5. So I will enter into this if condition. Then I will change the distance of V7. Distance of V7 will be 1 plus 4, which is 5. So I will be changing these two values. I will write 5 over here and V4 over here. I will change this value also to 5. So I have done with V7. Next we have V5. So first we will be checking the status of the known value. None of V5 is false, so we can enter inside this if condition. Now we will check the distance parameters. Distance of V5 currently is infinity. So whether infinity is greater than distance of V4 is 1 plus the distance from V4 to V5 is 2. Okay, so obviously infinity is greater than 3. So I will have to run these two conditions. So I will be changing these two values. I need to change this value also. So the distance is 3, the path is from V4, and the distance is written over here as well. Okay, so we have done with the case of V5 also. Okay, so the distance to V1 is 0, V2 is 2, V3 is 3, V4 it is 1, to V5 it is 3, and to V6 it is 9. To V6 it is 9 and to V7 it is 5. So we have done with the vertex V4. Now we are coming back to the while loop again. Now we will take the smallest unknown distance vertex. So the unknown vertices are V2, V3 and V5, V6, V7. Out of them the smallest one is V2 because it has got the smallest distance, that is 2. Okay, so now the value of V is V2, and this vertex is not null, so it will not break the loop. Now we will assign none of V2 is equal to true. Okay, so I'm doing that. The none of V2 is equal to true. Okay, now we are going to check every adjacent vertex of V2. So for the vertex V2, we have two adjacent vertices, that is V4 and V5. So it is V4 and V5. So out of them, V4 is known already because you can see that the value known for V4 is 1. So we do not want to execute these conditions as far as V4 is concerned. Now we will turn our attention to V5 alone. So the distance of V5 is currently 3. Now we are checking whether it is greater than the distance to V2 plus the distance from V2 to V5. So distance to V2 is 2, distance to V2 to V5 is 10. So this condition is not true, so we will not have to do anything inside the if statement. Okay, so we are done with the case of V5 as well. Okay, so there is no change for the distances. The only change that happened is we just changed the noun status of V2. Now I will remove all these variables. And moving on, we will now consider the smallest unknown distance vertex. So the unknown vertices are V3, V5, V6 and V7. Out of them, two vertices has the smallest distances, that is V3 and V5. So we will take V3 because that comes first in the list. It doesn't matter which way you take, you can take V3 or V5. I'm just choosing V3. So the smallest unknown vertex is V3. And V3 is not null, so it will not break the loop. Now we will assign the noun status of V3 to 1. So I'm doing that. The noun status of V3 is 1. Okay. So V3 has two adjacent vertices. One is V1, the other one is V6. Okay. So we have V1 and V6. And out of them, V1 is already known. That is, this value indicates. So we do not have to consider V1 at all. Now we have to consider V6. Now we are checking the noun status of V6, whether it is true or false. The value is false, so we can execute this if conditions. Okay, so we will be checking the condition. The distance to V6 now is 9. Is it greater than the distance to V is V3. Distance to V3 is 3 plus the distance from V3 to V6. The distance from V3 to V6 is 5. So I'll be writing that 5 over here. Okay. Now you can see that this 9 is greater than 3 plus 5 will be 8. Okay. This is 8. So this condition is true. So we have to update the distance of the vertex V6 to 8. And we had to put the path variable also. For V6, we had to change the distance variable as well as the path variable. So the distance value is 8, the path value is V3 because we have to come from V3 to reach V6. Okay, so I'm updating that cost here as well. It will not be 9, it will be the new value 8. Okay, so we have done with the case of V6 also. Now we are going to the while condition. It is true. Now we are taking the smallest unknown distance vertex. So we have three different possibilities, V5, V6 and V7, out of which the smallest one is V5. So we will take V as V5. Now we will check whether that vertex is null or not. So it is not null. Now we will assign the noun status of V5 equal to true. So I am changing this value, noun of V5 equal to true. Now we are going to examine the neighbors of V5. So V5 has got one neighbor, that is V7. So the neighbor of V5 is V7. Now we are checking whether the vertex V7 is known or not. So it is not known. So we will enter into this if condition. Now we will be calculating the distance to V7. V7 now it has a distance of 5. Now we are checking whether it is greater than the distance to V5 is 3 and the distance from V5 to V7 is 6. So this will be 9. 5 is not greater than 9, so this is false. So we will not be entering inside this if condition. Okay, so we can do with the vertex V7 also. Now we have to go to this while loop to look for the smallest unknown vertex. The smallest unknown vertex among these two are V7. Okay, so I'll be taking the value of V as V7. So V7 is not null, so I will not break the while loop. Now we will update the noun status of V7 to true. So I'm doing that over here. The noun status of V7 is 1. Okay, now we will examining the adjacent vertex of V7. The V7 has only one adjacent vertex, that is V6. Now we will check the adjacent vertices of V7. V7 has only one adjacent vertex, that is V6. Now we will check the noun status of V6. V6 has got the noun value equal to 0. So this condition is true. Now we will execute these statements. So first we have to calculate the distance to W, W is V6. The distance to V6 is currently 8. And if it is greater than the distance to V, V is V7. So distance to V7 is 5 plus the distance from V7 to V6, that is 8. So this condition is actually true because 8 is greater than the value 6. So we have to update the distance of V6 to 6. Okay. So I am updating that here. So distance to V6 is 6 and the path is from V7. Okay. 6 and V7. Okay. I will update that value here also. This should be 6. Okay. And it should be from V7. So we have done with it. Now we will go to the while condition again. We will check the smallest unknown distance vertex. The smallest unknown distance vertex is V6. So V6 is not null, so it will not break the loop. Now I will be assigning the known status of V6 to true. So the known status of V6 should be true or 1. Okay. Now I am checking all the adjacent vertices of that vertex V6. So V is V6. Now we are checking the adjacent vertices of V6. So you can see that V6 does not have any adjacent vertices. So we will not have to do anything over here. Now we will come back to the while condition again. Now we will take the smallest unknown distance vertex. So we do not have any unknown vertex over here. So this will be null. So we will check if V equal to null. So V is currently null, because we do not have anything as a smallest unknown distance vertex. So it will break my while loop. Imagine that you have to find the path that goes to V6. Then you have to look for what should be the previous vertex to V6. So that could be taken from the value of path. So to reach V6, you have to travel from V7. Okay. Now we will be checking what should be the node to be taken if we want to reach V7. So that is this vertex V4. So we have to take V4 to reach V7. Now what is the vertex that should be taken to reach V4? So it should be V1. Okay, that is the value V1. Okay. V1. So the shortest path to V6 will be this path, V1 to V4, V4 to V7 and V7 to V6. So I will mark it over here. V1 to V4. V4 to V7 and V7 to V6. So this will take a cost of 6. Okay, so that is the shortest distance and the shortest path is this one. Okay, similarly you can find the path to any other vertex. Now we will quickly run the algorithm on this graph without using any intermediate variables or the step-by-step procedure. The idea is rather simple. Initially, I have to assign the starting vertex with a distance 0 and all other vertices with distance infinity. Now we have to select the smallest distance among all these vertices. So I'll be selecting V1. So this is equivalent to marking a vertex as non. Now we will calculate the distance from this vertex to all of its neighbors. If the distance that we are calculating is less than the already existing distances with the vertices, we will enter the new value, otherwise we will not change. Okay. So V1 has two vertices, that is V2 and V4. The distance from V1 to V2 is 2. If the distance to V1 is 0, then which is less than infinity. The distance to V4 is currently infinity. So if you calculate the distance from V1 to V4, that is 1, this value. So which is also less than infinity. So we will update these two values with the new value. So I will be taking off these two infinity values. Then this will be 2 and this will be 1. Now I have to check for the smallest distance among all the vertices in my graph except this one, which is already marked as non. So we have a value V4. So I will be choosing this one as the next starting point. Okay. Now starting from V4, I will calculate the distance to all of its neighbors. If the new distance is less than the already existing distance, I will update the distance with the new value. Otherwise, keep the old value there itself. Okay. So all the values are infinity, which will be obviously greater than the new value. So I will be removing all the infinity values. So the neighbors of V4 are V3, V6, V7 and V5. So the distance from V4 to V3 is 2. So distance to V4 is 1. So 1 plus 2 will be 3. Then 1 plus 8 will be 9. 1 plus 4 will be 5. Then 1 plus 2 will be 3. Okay. Now we have to check for the smallest distance among all these vertices. So we have a value 2, 3, 3, 9 and 5. So I will choose the V2 as the next vertex to start from. So this is marked as not. Now I will calculate the distances from this V2 to its neighbors. So V2 has two neighbors. One is V4, another one is V5. So the distance to V4 is already done because we have marked it as known. So the only unknown vertex is V5. The new distance will be 2 plus 10, that is 12. The presently existing distance is 3. So there is no need of ablation. So I will keep it as it is. Now I have to look for the smallest unknown vertices. So we have the vertices V3, V5, V6 and V7. Among these four vertices, we have two values which are same for two vertices, that is 3 for V3 and V5. I will select V3. You can also choose V5, doesn't matter. Now I will check its neighbors, that is V1 and V6. So V1 is already known, so we don't need to consider it. So I will check the distance to V6. The present distance is 9. The new distance would be 3 plus 5, that is 8, which is less than the presently existing distance 9. So I will change it. So this can be removed and update it with 8. Okay. So we have done with the vertex V3. Now we have to look for the smallest value. Now we have the unknown vertices V5, V6 and V7. So I will select V5 because it has the smallest distance. Starting from V5, I will check all of its neighbors. So V5 has only one neighbor, that is V7. The presently existing distance is 5 and the new distance would be 3 plus 6, that would be 9. So I do not need to update it. So we have done with the vertex V5. Now we will check for the smallest distance vertex among these two vertices, which is V7. So I will select V7. Now I will calculate the distance from V7 to V6, that will be 5 plus 1. Which will be 6, which is less than the value 8. So I will remove the value 8 and update it with 6. Okay, so we have done with this vertex also. Now we will select that smallest distance vertex, that is V6. We will mark it as known, so we have marked it. Now we will check for the neighbors of this vertex. So this does not have any neighbors, so we are done. So the smallest distance to each of the vertex from this vertex V1 will be these values written in green color. Okay, this logic can be applied to any graph where we need to find the shortest path and shortest distance using the Dijkstra's shortest path algorithm. Now let's quickly run the algorithm on this graph also. This graph is an undirected graph, which means we do not have any directions, so we can take either direction from one vertex to another vertex. Now my aim here is to find the shortest path as well as the shortest distance to the vertex G starting from A. So the distance to A will be 0 because it is the starting vertex. Then I will be initializing all the distances to other vertices as infinity to begin with. Okay. Now I will choose this vertex as the known vertex. Now I will calculate the distances to all of its neighbors. So A has got 3 neighbors, B, D as well as E. So I will be calculating the distances to those vertices from A. So the distances will be from A to B, that is 3, not infinity. So which is less than infinity, so we can update that value. The distance to A to D is 17, which is less than infinity. I can update that value as well. The distance to E is 32, so I can update that value as well. So I'm updating those values. So this will be 3. The distance here will be 17. The distance here will be 32. Okay, now I need to choose the smallest distance among the all unknown vertices. So we have all vertices as unknown except the vertex A. So the smallest one is the vertex B. So we will be taking this vertex B. Then we will calculate the distances to all of its unknown neighbors. B has 3 vertices as its neighbors, A, D as well as C. So we will not be considering A because it is already known.
So we will be considering only D as well as C. So we will calculate the distance to C from B. So starting from B, the distance to C is 3 plus 18, which is 21, which is of course less than infinity. So I can update that value. So I will be removing this value. Similarly, the distance to D will be 3 plus 2, which is 5, which is less than 17. So I can update that value as well. So the distance to C will be now 21. The distance to D will be now 5. Okay. So we have calculated the distances from the vertex B. Now we will be choosing the smallest vertex among all these vertices. We have 5, 21, infinity, infinity, and 32. So I'll be choosing the vertex D, which has got a value 5. So I will mark this vertex as the non-vertex. Then from this vertex, I will calculate the distances to all of its unknown neighbors. B is known, A is known, but F is not known. So I will calculate the distance to F. So F has a distance presently which is infinity. So I will calculate the new distance as 5 plus 5, which is 10. Okay. Now I do not have any other unknown vertex as far as the vertex D is concerned. Now we will look for all the unknown vertices which has the smallest value. So we can see that F has got the smallest value. So I will mark F as known. I will look for all of its neighbors which are unknown. So C is unknown, G is unknown, E is unknown, and D is already known. So the new distances to C will be this 10 plus 2, which will be 12. Okay. And the new distance to E will be 10 plus 1, which will be 11, which is less than 32. So I will update it. And the new distance to G will be 10 plus 1, which is 11. Which is less than infinity, so I can remove it. So the new distance will be 11. Okay. Now I will look for the smallest distance vertices among C, G, E because they are unknown. Now I will choose E. Now I will look for all of its unknown neighbors. So the unknown neighbors of E is only G because F is known, A is already known. So I'll be choosing G. So distance from E to G will be 11 plus 2, which will be 13. So which is greater than this already existing distance. So I do not need to update it. Next, I will be choosing the vertex G. I will mark G as known. Now I will calculate the distance from G to all of its unknown neighbors. So G has only one unknown neighbor, which is the vertex C. So the distance to C is currently 12. If I calculate it from G, it will be 11 plus 8, which is greater than 12. So I do not consider it. So the value 12 will be remaining with the vertex C. Now I need to select the smallest unknown vertex. So C is the smallest unknown vertex. Now if you look at this one, this doesn't have any unknown neighbors. So I can stop the procedure over there. So the path to G will be from A to B, then B to D, then D to F and F to G. That is giving me the distance 11. So this is the smallest distance that I can get from A to G. Okay. So the path is A to B to D, then to F, then to G, and this will have a distance of 11. Okay. So I hope the idea is clear. Thank you.